Can Jim talk about hell in less than 7 minutes? No. That's why we have to do a part two. So we're going to continue talking on our conversation about hell.
Yeah, it's a big conversation, and obviously a lot of us care. You had an interesting question at the end of our last conversation off tape.
Yeah.
And let's go back to that question.
Yeah, so basically I've heard the conversation about with the necessity of hell and the gospel, right? There's a person who's basically said, like, if they don't know what they're being saved from, then what's the point in being saved?
Yeah.
And so they made hell a necessity to the
essential
gospel.
Essential to the gospel. Yeah. So part of that would be, if there's no bad news, why do you need good news?
Right.
You know? What good is the good news of Jesus if there is no bad news? There's a guy named Ray Comfort. Interesting name because he is a hellfire brimstone guy.
Oh no!
But he tells it this way. This example. He said if you're on a commercial jet, you know, flying to wherever, and somebody tells you, hey, put on this parachute, man. You are gonna love this parachute. It's gonna make your life better. You're gonna have a better marriage. You're gonna have a better life. You're gonna have better kids. Your whole life's gonna improve. Just put this backpack on, and it changes everything. And so you put on that backpack and you look around and nobody else has a backpack, a parachute on, and it's uncomfortable. You can't sit right. It's kind of cumbersome to your life. And you're like, why do I need this? And you take that thing off and you throw it away. But if we told you, put this on because this plane is going to crash and this is going to save your life. That's kind of the same question. Like, if I don't know why I need saving, then why is the message of salvation of any interest to me?
Mm-hmm.
So I think I've never been a fan of scaring the hell out of people.
Right.
My brother came to faith in Christ watching A Thief in the Night, this black and white film about the rapture, and he gave his heart to Christ. And, you know, a few years later, he went into cocaine addiction and the wheels fell off, and now he's back to Christ. But his relationship with Christ now is not fear-based. That's the thing that the whole hell conversation does. Well, I better go to Jesus because I'm scared to death of hell.
Mm.
And that was never the selling card of Jesus. Jesus is, the good news is, the kingdom of God has come.
Mm-hmm.
So this hellacious life you're living now can have the kiss of God upon it and the gap you feel between you and God and even the damage to your own soul, you know, that nagging sense, something's not right. He came to bring the kingdom of God to that. He came to fix what was broke and to restore what has been stolen. So it is your kindness, O God, that leads us to repentance,
yeah,
not the fear of hell. And yet, hell was a part of the gospel. It was a part of the conversation. So I think I would lean towards, if you don't know the bad news, then the good news loses a bit of its captivity to you.
Sure. I think that the way I process it in my mind, and I don't want to say that I disagree, but I don't.
Yeah.
I think that the way that I think about it is more or less that, like, I guess, like, the good news is still worth it because it's the conversation of God.
Yeah.
It's the most valuable conversation because if there's a God who loves you, that you can know who created the whole universe,
yeah.
I mean, what, and, you know what I mean? Like,
that's exactly where I land.
Yeah.
I think maybe there's some personality basis here because...
Sure.
If you are, like, I was studying this concept that there are basically four temperament types of how we respond to things and how we're motivated.
Right.
Four ways of being motivated. And one person is the rebel. And the thing about the rebel is the rebel can establish new boundaries for themselves. Like, I'm going to get out of bed at 6:30 every morning and read my Bible. And the rebel will desire to rebel against their own rule. Because their motivation is rebellion.
Yeah.
It could be that that person needs to fully understand the high price of rebellion against God.
Right.
And so there may be some personality and temperament to that too. You know,
right.
The compliant personality versus the non-compliant personality.
Yeah.
I certainly raised my kids in different ways. And, you know, my oldest son, he needed to know the high price his rebellion was going to cost him. The promise of intimacy with his dad and this wonderful family life, it was not an attraction to him.
Mm. Yeah, no, that makes more sense with it. Because I think a lot of times, for me, that's what I needed. Like, when I got saved, God told me, son, I love you. And I heard it. And that's what I needed.
And it's like, I'm in.
That's what I needed.
I love this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But I
feel the same way.
For other people, they needed a rude awakening.
And I'm a compliant kid, you know, my whole life. My dad was authoritarian. Two of the kids were like, yeah, dad, you know, they're going to rebel. And I was like, you mean you can break the rules? Who ever heard of such a thing? All I wanted was my dad's approval. and his affection in that relationship. So I was willing to pay a price for it.
Yeah.
Other people say, I want my own adventure and thrill, whatever.
Because I think the thing I definitely avoid with it is not the convenience of the conversation, right? Because it's more convenient to avoid a bad thing, right? Sure. If you can avoid the conflict of it, then that's fine. And I don't think that that's my goal in it. It's just I don't think...
You could do the same thing with the return of Christ. Right. Like, he's coming back. Mm-hmm. All right? He's coming back. All the prophecies required for his return have been satisfied. So we're not waiting on any global event to finalize the return of Jesus. Everything that was prophetically required for the second coming has been satisfied since 1948 when Jerusalem became a nation. So he could come at any moment. It is the imminent return of Christ.
Yeah.
So how should we live? Should we be telling people, hey, the clock's ticking, bro. You might not have tomorrow from your own mortality, from the coming of Jesus. Again, that's a scare tactic. All of sales is hope of gain, fear of loss.
Right.
And people are motivated. Some are motivated entirely by hope of gain. And some are motivated by fear of loss.
Right.
And that's why it is the whole story.
Yeah.
God loves us, wants intimacy with us, wants us to flourish. We gave him the finger.
Yeah.
The rest of history is the playing out of that ongoing wrestle. Am I going to submit to God or am I going to live for myself? That battle is going to wage, and that piece of the bad news has got to be part of the good news.
Yeah.
I think.
Well, I think that to every good story, there has to be some sort of conflict, right? There has to be some outcome to it that makes it worth watching.
And man, the stakes are high. You're going to be dead a long time.
Yeah.
Eternity is a long time. One of my favorite descriptions of eternity is if you take a giant steel ball the size of the earth, and every million years it swings on this pendulum, and on a million years it comes back to center and there's a blade and it just shaves a little piece off. After that ball becomes dust, eternity has just begun.
Yeah.
Like, you're going to be in eternity a long, long time. So it's a legitimate conversation. Hey, let's get this right.
Yeah.
Because you do have an eternal destiny that is super significant. It's awe-inspiring.
Yeah.
Whichever way it goes, it's an awe-inspiring eternal destiny.
Yeah. So, hey, this conversation is, I think we've set up the bones for saying that this conversation is worth having no matter what you believe. Mm-hmm. Like, plain and simple, and to be amenable together about having this conversation regardless of the disagreement. But I think it's the most of value to have about Christ and faith and destination and all those things. I think it's all worth having a conversation about. So don't let it stop here. Go ahead and comment down below any questions, any comments, ideas that you have. As always, hit that ECC logo so you can subscribe. Don't forget the bell so that you always know when we're coming out with videos. And we'll see you guys next week.